Yes, good morning, beta. One question from Hirul's formula is pending that we will do at the end. Now let's start with a new chapter, that is your linear equation in two variables. In the junior classes, you must have listened about the term algebraic expression, which is a combination of variables as well as numbers. If I write 2x plus 3y, so x and y are variables and 2 and 3 are the numbers here. So they are combined with each other with different operations. Okay, so this is your expression because it is a combination of numbers and variables. In the same manner, if I write x, y, z, all the three variables are multiplying. So it is your again algebraic expression. In the same way, if I write 3y plus 4z minus 8, so this is again the combination of numbers and variable. So it is again an algebraic expression. Now, linear equation is same as this, but it will be in two variables. Like you can see that here I have written two variables. So this is your linear equation. This is your linear equation in two variables, y and z. As it represents your equation, so it must have equality sign. If no equality sign is there, that means it is your expression. If equality sign is there, then it will become your equation. Okay, so let's write the definition of this linear equation in two variables. Write down linear equation in two variable. I'm speaking up the definition of linear equation in two variable. The equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, the equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers, where a, b, c are real numbers. Real numbers means they can be in the root, they can be in the fraction, they can be in the decimal form. A, B, C are real number. A and B are not equal to 0. A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0. Because if I take A equal to 0, this term will become 0 and this equation will remain in one variable. But we are discussing in two variables. So that's why the coefficient of X and Y should not be 0 in any case. Okay. So this is the necessary condition that the one mark question can be asked in the exam. What is the necessary condition for this equation to be a linear equation in two variable? Is that the coefficient of x and y should not be zero. Because if it will be zero, then the equation will no longer be a linear equation in two variable. Okay. A and b not equal to zero. X and y are variables. X and y are variables. Then it is called linear equation in two variable. Then it is called linear equation in two variable. Is it okay? I'm again repeating the definition. You please check it out. An equation of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers. A and B not equal to 0, X and Y are variables, is called the linear equation in two variable. Okay. If I write, now we are discussing few example, few one mark question I'm discussing that is based on exactly this concept. If I write 2X plus root 3y minus 7 equal to 0. Can you tell me the value of a from here? A, b, c. A is 2, b is your root 3, and c is your minus 7. Actually, the general form of the equation is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So if you compare this equation with ax plus by plus c equal to 0, a is 2, b is root 3, c is minus 1, minus 7, okay? Now write one more. If I write x minus 4 is equal to root 3y Now, I have written one more equation, but it is not in the general form. What you will do is you will convert this to the general form. So for converting it to the general form, what you will do, you will write this in this form. We want the term that contain x, then y, then constant. So this is your x, this y will be shifted to this side and minus 4 will be same. We have just changed the place of this term. We have brought this term to the left side. So it will change the sign and this is your ax plus by plus c equal to 0. A is equal to 1. B is equal to minus root 3. C is equal to minus 4. Okay. Any problem? Any problem, beta? Now see one more example. Wait. Divya, okay. Next is 4 is equal to 5x minus 3y. So this is 5x minus 3y. This constant you will brought to the next side. This is your ax plus by plus c equal to 0. You will always compare the given equation with the general form. A is equal to 5, B is equal to minus 3, C is equal to minus 4. So these are the values of A, B, and C. Is it clear? Now let's start with the exercise 4.1. You will write definition of the linear equation, then you will start exercise. Exercise 4.1. The cost of the notebook is twice that of the cost of pen. Cost of notebook is twice that of the cost of the pen. The thing that is given at the last place, you will suppose it first. Let the cost of one pen is X rupees and the cost of one notebook is Y rupees. You can take vice versa also. Let cost of one pen is X, cost of one notebook is Y. Cost of notebook means Y is matlab equal to twice that of the cost of pen. This condition is given. Cost of the notebook is twice the cost of the pen. Write the linear equation in two variables. Now this become Y is equal to 2X. Now you have to convert it into two variable. This is already in two variable, but you have to write it in the general form. So this is 2x minus y, 0 equal to 0. Y we have shifted here, it will become negative and no constant term is there. So I have written 0. This is your ax plus by plus c equal to 0. A is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 1, c is equal to 0.
मैम प्लीज तो लाइट बंद कर दो, ये सारे सब पे लाइट पड़ रही है तो लाइट में दिख नहीं रहा क्या लिखा हुआ है।
वेट, धैर्य, इज इट क्लियर नाउ?
मैम पेन वाई एंड नोटबुक एक्स है।
कोई बात नहीं, आप एग्जाम में हिंट थोड़ी आएगा साथ में, आप जैसे मर्जी ले लो। ठीक
ओके मैम,
है, ये तो यहाँ आपको दिया हुआ ना, एग्जाम में थोड़ी आएगा हिंट, तो आप जो मर्जी सपोज कर सकते हो। ठीक है, क्लियर है। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर टू। क्वेश्चन नंबर टू इज एग्जैक्टली सेम दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द एग्जाम्पल। Express the following linear equation in ax plus by plus c and indicate the value of abc. Means you have to write the value. Firstly, you have to write them in the form ax plus by plus c. So c should be there with this. What you will do is you will shift this term on the left hand side. The sign will change. This is your ax plus by plus c equal to 0, a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, c is equal to minus 9.35 bar. Okay, start the next part. Now you have to answer me each and every part. Start the second part. Take LCM first. Note down these two parts and start the second part of this question. Take LCM. Have you taken LCM? Take LCM. Question number two, B part. X minus Y by 5 minus 10 equal to 0. Take LCM. LCM will be 5. This will become 0. When you shift this here, it will become 0. AX. A is equal to 5. B is equal to minus 1. C is equal to minus 50.
Hi, please, ma'am.
Third part is same, you can do. Fourth part, x is equal to 3y. Now convert this into general form of the linear equation, that is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. X minus 3y plus 0 equal to 0. A is equal to 1. B is equal to minus 3. C equal to 0. Next is 2x is equal to minus 5y. 2x plus 5y plus 0 equal to 0. Actually, constant term is missing. So I have written 0 at its place. A is equal to 2. B is equal to 5, C is equal to 0. Yes, look here, beta. Have you notice one thing, x is there, but y is missing. X is there, but y is missing in this. So what you will do, you will write 0y प्लस टू इक्वल टू जीरो, थ्री एक्स प्लस जीरो वाई प्लस टू इक्वल टू जीरो, ए एक्स प्लस बी वाई प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो, ए इज इक्वल टू थ्री, बी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सी इज इक्वल टू टू. एनी डाउट इन दिस? एनी डाउट बेटा? In the next part, y minus 2 equal to 0. Here x is missing. So what you will do, you will write 0x, this is 1y, this thing is same, but I have just written 0x. Here, this thing I have written same, y was missing, so I have written 0y. In this case also, this is ax plus by plus c equal to 0, a is equal to 0, b is equal to 1, c is equal to minus 2. Solve the next part, eighth part. Yes, we need graph in this chapter, so be ready with the graph tomorrow. Next question, who will answer me? Yes, Brijesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Speak up the standard form of 5 is equal to 2x.
Yes, ma'am.
Question is 5 is equal to 2x. If we want to write it in the standard form, then it will become
5 by 2.
Yes. X wali term hai
2x.
5 by 2 is the solution. Wo solution hai, wo nahi pucha. Maine aapko bola is form mein kaise represent karenge. 5 is equal to 2x hai. Y ki term missing hai. Kya ho jayega?
Zero.
Bolo na equation kya banegi? टू एक्स प्लस जीरो वाई और फाइव उस साइड पे, उसको इस साइड पे शिफ्ट करो, क्या हो जाएगा?
माइनस फाइव.
क्या बन गई इक्वेशन?
टू एक्स प्लस जीरो वाई प्लस माइनस फाइव
इक्वल टू जीरो. लिखो, राइट डाउन, टू एक्स प्लस जीरो वाई माइनस फाइव इक्वल टू जीरो. ए क्या है इसमें
मैम? ए टू है.
यस, ए टू. बी
B zero,
very good. And C is
minus five.
Minus
five.
Yes, ठीक है. ये करो start. Yes, everyone, make this in the standard form. Brijesh बोलो, x is equal to minus five. Standard form बोलो इसकी.
मैम x प्लस जीरो वाई प्लस फाइव इक्वल टू जीरो. x मैम वन, a वन हो गया,
हाँ
जी. y जीरो हो गया, ओ b जीरो हो गया, और c फाइव हो गया.
यस, ओके. स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म इज दीपकीर्ति, चार्वी, अर्शिता, गगन, गुरशान. Those who are not responding, I will remove them from the class. Harmeet, Havish, yes, raise your hand whose name I have taken. General form is x plus 0y plus 5 equal to 0. Write down next. Y is equal to 2. Y is equal to 2. Write this in the standard form. Jia, Jaydev, Karan.
Yes, ma'am.
Bolo beta. standard form of this?
Ma'am, 0x plus 1y plus 2 is minus 2 is equal to 0.
A is?
A 0, B 1, C 2, minus 2.
C minus 2. A 1, sorry, A 0, B 1, C minus 2. Okay, can you do one more? 5y is equal to 2. Write in the standard form. Rishikesh. Lisa. Prachi. Aryan. Raghav.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Raghav. 5x plus
ma'am.
5y is equal to 2. What is the general form of this?
Ma'am, 0x plus 5y minus 2 is equal to 0.
Yes. A is
0, y is 5, c is minus 2.
Okay. Okay, yes.
Thank you, ma'am. Awesome. Okay.
Prachi, mark Shabad as absent because he is entering at 9. Okay? Mark him absent. Yes, Aryan? Yes, Aryan? Yes, look here. I'm writing one example, that is x plus 2y is equal to 6. Find four different solutions of this. Find four different solutions. Put x equal to 0. Agar aap 0 put karte ho, to y ki value kya aajayegi? 3. Agar aap x ko 0 put karte ho, y kya aa raha hai? If you put x is equal to 1, then put here 1. 1 plus 2y is equal to 6. 2y is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 by 2. First solution aapka aa raha hai 0, 3. Second solution aa raha hai 1, 5 by 2. How you will find the third solution? Yes, Bhavansh. Can you tell me how you can find the third solution of this? Charvi, Bhavansh.
Ma'am, put x is equal to 2.
X equal to 2. You can put any number. Either it will be positive or it will be negative.
X equal to 3 bhi kar sakte hain.
Kar sakte hain, haan ji. X is equal ma'am. To minus 1 bhi kar sakte hain. Minus 1 kar le. Kuch bhi kar sakte hain. But be sure that you are doing correct calculation. X ki jagah minus 1 likh diya. You can put any number. 100, 50, 30, 40, as your wish. So 2y is equal to 7, y is equal to 7 by 2. Then the third solution is minus 1, 7 by 2. Can you tell me what is this? What I have written? This is the coordinate. This is the coordinate. Actually, whenever you are making the graph or the line, you will always plot them on the coordinate axis. And that will give you the coordinate as your solution. So each is the solution and that will be in the coordinate form. Put x is equal to 3. Chalo, 3 put kar lete. You can put any number. We don't have any problem. Answer is 3, 3 by 2. Yes. Can you tell me how many such solutions we can have? Yes, Harman. How many such solutions can be formed? because we have infinite numbers, and on putting infinite number you will always get infinite solution. So that means every equation has infinite solution. Every equation, not this particular equation, if we talk about any equation, that will give you infinite solution. Is it clear how to find the four solution of the equation? You can find more also. Now, can you answer me the first equation of 4.2? Havish? Yes, everybody read out the first question of 4.2. Karan? Unyasa? Surveen? Aryan? Raghav Duggal? Pushti? Ashna? One equation is given, that is y is equal to 3x plus 5. What type of solution it is giving? Unique solution? Only two solution? Yeah, infinite.
Ma'am, infinite. Infinite.
Yes, it will give you infinite.
Ma'am, infinitely many solutions.
Yes, so answer is third part, because for every equation you have infinite many solutions. Yes, start the question number two, first part. Equation is given, you have to write four solutions. Put x equal to 0, then y equal to 0, then x equal to 1, y equal to 1. You can put x as minus 1, y as minus 2, anything you want to put. Hurry up. Get the three solution of the first question, second question 4.2. We have discussed one question, so you will be having homework from this. I'm not doing, you will do at your own. Hurry up. Second part is different, that we will discuss tomorrow. I will do it for you. But now you will do question number two, first part. Who will tell me the solution? If you put zero, then what will be the solution? Yes, Gagan? Harmeet? Navya? Magan? Riddhima? Risham? Only few students are responding, rest of all are sleeping. Arshita? Riddhima? Risham? Raise your hand. If you put x equal to 0, yes, Riddhima?
Yes, ma'am.
If you put x equal to 0, then what will be the value of y? Again, you have muted yourself. Very good. If you put x equal to 0, then y equal to 7. The solution ho gaya 0, 7. If you put y 0, then answer is 7 by 2. तो सेकंड आपका सॉल्यूशन हो गया 7/2, 0. इफ यू पुट एक्स इक्वल टू 0 देन वाई इज 5. तो थर्ड सॉल्यूशन एक्स 1 वाई 5 1, 5. इफ यू पुट वाई इक्वल टू 1 देन एक्स इज इक्वल टू 3 3, 1. सो आई हैव स्पोकन थ्री सॉल्यूशन फोर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस. डू थर्ड पार्ट. डू थर्ड पार्ट. हरी अप. Do third part of this question. Yes, mark down the homework. Exercise 4.1. Question number 1. Question number 2. Second and fourth part. Question number 1 and question number 2, second and fourth part.